So you know of my ambition to be the most feared Locust pilot in the inner sphere, the most feared Locust pilot on YouTube, on there. And continuing our mech reviews, the Cicada seems like a good jump up. If you're pretty good with a Locust, and you've worked your way through the different Locust variants on there, and you get a promotion, you get some C-bills, why not jump into a Cicada? So I look at the Cicada, 650, 6-something battle value. Pretty good. Medium lasers, best weapon in the game in terms of heat, damage, range. It's got two of them. You know, we're looking stock, so you've got some redundancy on there. It's got a small laser, but okay. Good speed, excellent armor. Really not bad for a light mech. Then you look at the technical manual some more, and you realize, wait, based on the tonnage, this is a medium mech on there. So it's expected to fulfill a medium mech role. It seems a little bit undergunned on there. It seems like it should have a little bit more of a long-range punch. What we see with light mechs, really quick, like the weapons breakdown, because this is important for framing the Cicada, light mechs will have one primary weapon and some backup weapons. Think about the Locust stock. You got the medium laser, you got the machine guns. You're never really intended to use any of those. You're a spotter mech, you're a recon mech, maybe you'll fire off a few shots with the medium laser here and there, you'll skirmish, but essentially you're always running and you have your speed. If you find yourself as a light mech pilot, as a Locust pilot shooting off the machine guns and that medium laser, there's some challenges going on. Then when we move into the medium mechs, what you're going to see is you usually have one type of long-range weapon. There might be something like the Griffin that has the PPC and the LRM paired. That's possible. But for the most part, it's like I give you one long-range weapon, Shadowhawk, you know, the auto cannon on there. And then you have one, two, or three more closer-range weapons. So the idea is, and I've got some good speed and some decent armor, I'm going to ping at you, with that long-range weapon. And then when we close, we're going to skirmish. We're going to go back and forth with the closer-ranged weapons. And if I need to withdraw or if I need to hop around or tactically run and gun, I can do that. Then we move into heavy-type mechs. And we'll just kind of leave this piece here. We move into heavy mechs where you have a couple of long-range weapons. But really, then you close to all of your braced array of medium lasers and short-range missiles and things like that. And, of course, in each weight class, there are very, very specialized mechs that intend to fill one role, you know, like the longbow is on there. So, or the Panther for a light mech on there. It's a light mech hunter, in theory, although Panther's pretty interesting. So when we have the Cicada, what I'm expecting to see is one long-range weapon and then maybe a brace of one or two medium or short-range weapons. So I can use that speed to get into position, snipe with the long-range weapon, and then when needed, switch over to those medium-type range weapons. Well, that's called a Griffin. That's called a Shadowhawk. Do I really need a heavy recon mech in my lance? That's essentially what it is. The Cicada's designed to heavy recon into a well-defended area. Not that I want to take a few hits, but I could take a hit here and there. And then if I'm harassed or followed by light mechs, in theory, with the ability to rotate in the position of the medium lasers, I can shoot at them on there. You know, either if they're trying to block me, run interference, or chase after me. That's a very, very mission-specific role. If you're like Fritz, go in there and recon, you know, Cicada's pretty good. And I played a Cicada. I have it in my collection. You know, I enjoy playing it. But if it's like, let's build a lance, let's go into no man's land and skirmish it out, you know, the Cicada is challenging. Because with those medium lasers, it has the redundancy to effectively utilize those. I need to get at long or medium range for those lasers. That puts me in an interesting place where the brace of weapons on the medium mechs, the brace of weapons for the heavy mechs, I'm in range. I'm in potential range of all those. And I could take a couple of hits as a medium, but I still want to rely on that speed, on that massive amounts of speed for the Cicada to make that work. It's not to say I'm going to go toe-to-toe with a heavy mech, but a good mech commander, a competent lance, will keep all of their mechs relatively close with overlapping lanes of fire. So even if I'm going to gang up on that light mech on there, I'm going to be at medium or long range for attacks from the heavies, the assaults from the other mediums. It's not a bad mech, but I just wonder if there really is a need for a role for a medium recon mech. And we see this theme. On a side note, we see this theme in Battletech where in each weight class, there's kind of like multi-purpose all-contenders mech. So we see a bunch of those. Then we see mechs that are designed to hunt specifically that class of mech, you know, like the Panther, to hunt down light mechs. Then we see certain mechs defined for different roles, you know, recon, support. But the question here is like, light mechs, in terms of recon, you go with light mech. Do I need a medium recon mech? Do I need a heavy or an assault recon mech? I mean, I like playing the Charger for the lulls, but I mean, do I really need that type of mech in that capacity on there? And the Battletech narrative, the Battletech universe is different, of course, in that, you know, these are machines that are being sold, and you're selling them as a company. So it's like, look, we can do this. Do you want to buy it? I get it. But tactically on the tabletop, it's a little different.